program with There's Something About a Soldier.
Here I went her, with your ice and snow, frosty echoes in the valley, hidey, hidey, ho. Here I went her, dear old winter, dear old winter, boom!
That was Mary Livingston finishing the poem she started last week. And now, I bring to you our master of ceremonies, Jack Benny.
Hello again. This is Jack Benny, the Earth Galloper. Remember, coming to you with all the late news events through the courtesy of the Bronx Express, in conjunction with the literary Post Chronicle Gazette Journal of Red Hook, Long Island. Here we go. Athens, Greece. Sam Insull given 5 days to leave Greece. When he asked them where he could go, the Greeks had a word for it. Paris, France. France again elects president, is now one up on Cuba. Cuban president looks worried and threatens to even the score. The score is now even. New York, New York. Thermometer drops to 14 below zero, which establishes new record here. Union Square, New York. Weather so cold here that communists are now hitting each other with radiators. New York, New York. Famous screen actor Clark Gable arrives here from Hollywood during cold spells. 12 girls present him with a pair of earmuffs. More screen news. Greta Garbo also arrives here on shopping tour and gives wholesale order for a pair of shoes. When asked about her love affair with her director, Mamoulian, she said, no, 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 no. But from the look on Mamoulian's face, it is yes, 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 yes. However, that's none of our business. It is rumored that Frank Black will entertain these stars while in New York and has 4 slots reserved in the automat. More screen news. Jimmy Durante also heading east. His nose is already here, and Durante will arrive in the morning. More Garbo news. Garbo spends vacation taking in all the Broadway shows. When interviewed, said she would like to see Katharine Hepburn in The Lake. When Hepburn was interviewed, said she'd like to see Garbo in the Hudson River. Jealousy. That's all, folks. Pardon me. Flash, Park Avenue, New York, 9 p.m. 3,000 gigolos out on strike. They want the extra nickel the wives are giving their husbands for car fare. Flash, Flushing, Long Island. That should be Flush. 10 p.m. Man kills wife for bidding no Trump without a spade or diamond in her hand. 11 p.m. Man is acquitted and the bridge game continues. Moodus Colony, New Jersey. Flesh. Weather so cold here that groundhog goes back in his hole followed by nudist. Oh, they can't take it, eh?
Jack.
What is it, Mary?
Can I read one now?
Yes, Mary, but just fast, remember.
All right. New York, New York. Gold arrives here without a nose. When interviewed, says he still smells.
That's local, folks. Flash, NBC Studio, New York. Aloy Pavrilla, now standing on soapbox, addressing his Chevrolet audience.
And flashes come to us from everywhere that orders for the new 1934 Chevrolet are literally pouring into the factory.
Crash! Aloy Pavrilla falls off a soapbox.
Smash! Play Frank!
Very good. That was Frank Black and his orchestra playing the European song hit Without That Certain Thing. And now, say, Mary, I noticed you brought a couple of suitcases up to the studio tonight. Say, what's the idea?
Well, Jack, I'm going on a little vacation. Jealous?
No, Mary, I'm not jealous, but where are you going?
Where am I going? I'll give you 3 guesses. If you were me, where would you go this time of year?
Oh, I don't know. If I were you. Say, Black, if you were Mary and had a week off, where would you go?
Me? Well, I don't know. I like the Riviera, Nice, Monte Carlo.
That's a nice weekend trip, yes. You know, you can make that. Where would you go, Parker?
Oh, I'd take a little jaunt through Egypt, Africa, or maybe the Orient.
A little jaunt. A little hike through India would be nice for the weekend. How about you, Havril? I mean, where would you go if you had a week off?
Oh, I'd take a little sail down to the South Pole and see how Admiral Byrd is doing.
Of course, you'd stop off at New Zealand and pick up a sandwich.
You do get hungry being on the water all day.
Oh, certainly, of course. But what would you do after you got down to the South Pole?
Well, I like ice skating and hockey.
Oh, surely. Then in between times, you could introduce the knee action wheels down there, you know.
To whom?
Why, there's nothing down there but penguins. Well, their money's as good as anybody's, you know.
By the way, Jack, where would you like to go for a week?
Oh, I don't care particularly. You know, any place I hang my hat is home.
Yes, it hung in a speakeasy for 13 years.
Oh, you nasty individual.
Say, who's making this trip anyway?
Oh, I'm sorry, Mary. Silly, we sort of left you out of it. Well, I give up. Where are you going?
I'm going to Florida, Jack.
Oh, of course, Mary. Florida, down by the Gulf Stream.
Yes, and I'm taking my golf clubs with me.
You could have left that out. So you're going to Florida?
My, am I.
Oh, well. I know I didn't write that, but I get it. Say, tell me, Mary, on your way down there, I mean, are you going to stop at Daytona?
No, Jack, we don't go through Ohio.
Oh, we don't.
You know, there's a city down there I've always wanted to see. It's, everybody knows the name of it. It's,
What city? What?
Well, it's, I know the name so well.
Hurry up, Mary, I'm losing my temper.
That's your temper. Temper, Florida.
Oh.
It's a lively place.
Yes, and if you go through St. Petersburg, be sure to visit Frank Black's relatives. By the way, Mary, you know, I'm going away, too. Tomorrow, I'm going to Chicago to visit my sister.
See, that's swell. We'll be on the same train together as far as Montreal.
Mm-hmm. Montreal is in Canada.
Oh, pardon me. I was holding this map upside down.
Yes, I see. Now to get back to our program. Remember, folks, last week we had Opportunity Night in which we tried to find some new talent, and the result was disastrous. So having discovered nobody, tonight we are going back to our usual dramatic plays with our own all-star cast. And we'll offer for your pleasure our version of that great screen success, Little Women. You all remember the four charming daughters, Amy, Beth, Meg, and Jo. Well, our own Mary Livingston will play the part of Jo, a la Katharine Hepburn, while I, Jack Benny, will play the part of the millionaire's son next door. Say, Frank, could you let me have a few dollars? I want to get in the atmosphere of this part, you know.
No.
Well, I'll have to do some acting, then. And as many of you know, this play, Little Women, was written by Louisa M. Alcott over 50 years ago, which gave us plenty of time to rehearse and get our scenery together. And tonight is the big night. So immediately after the next number, we are going to offer our version of this famous play, which we will call Miniature Women. And now little Frankie Parker is going to entertain us, will tell you in his own inimitable way the name of the little song he's going to sing. Go ahead, Frankie.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to sing The Touch of Your Hand from Roberta.
Parker, you took the words right out of my mouth.
Play, Frank.
Frank Parker. And now for our dramatic offering, Small Dames. Miniature Women. Mary, are you ready?
Yes, Jack.
Do you feel Katharine Hepburn is this evening?
Hurry up, Jack. My train leaves for Florida in an hour.
Oh, yes. Okay, Mary. Oh, by the way, ladies and gentlemen, this play will be presented in two acts. The opening scene is in the home of Mrs. Little Woman and her four daughters. It is Christmas Eve, 1864. I think I'll stand in the entrance and watch the first scene. Curtain, music, Frank.
Children, look, Mama, the eye chipped in and brought you a nice Christmas. gonna like this, Mom.
You see, folks, these girls were brought up in different parts of New York, and it naturally affects their dialect, you know.
Oh, my darling. It's wonderful to remember your dear old mother like this. What did you bring me, children?
I brought you a nice pair of ice skates. Have a good time, Mama, and don't slip.
Mother's 75 years old, they bring her ice skates. Oh, well, it's the fourth.
Oh, thank you, children. I'll have these the first thing in the morning and buy some food.
I don't blame her. Hard to digest skates, you know.
Oh, girl, where's Joe? Didn't she come in with you?
No, Mama. I think she's out in the hen coop writing poetry.
At poetry?
Yeah, she's out in the hen coop writing poetry.
Poetry, poetry, poetry. That's all Joe thinks of. She's not writing poetry at all. I saw her out in the garden talking to that millionaire's son who lives next door.
I say she is. That's where I saw her, Mom, talking to that rich neighbor next door.
Cute little blonde from Dallas. I'm afraid we miscast this play.
Oh, that millionaire's son makes me sick. Always sending us presents, paying our rent, buying us food. We'd have starved a long time ago if he hadn't had us back.
That's a shame.
Oh, what's the matter, Mama? Why are you crying?
Oh, it's nothing, Jane. But sure, there must be something wrong. Tell us, Mother, what is it? I was just thinking, I only have four daughters, and Eddie Chandler has five.
Give Ida a little credit for that, Mom, you know.
Mom, who is that man that keeps butting in all the time?
I don't know, daughter. He's been hanging around ever since this play started.
Sure, he's always making vice crests.
Go along with you, dirty loafer, you.
Go on, folks. I'll see you later.
Come on, children. It's 4 o'clock, and it's about time you were in bed. Tomorrow is Christmas, you know.
Yes, Mama.
Good night, Jane.
Happy to Jane.
Good night, June, dear. Good night to your mother. Call me at 9 in the morning. Good night, June.
Good night, Mom. I hate to complain, but I'm feeling awful badly.
What's the matter, darling?
Oh, I don't know, Mom. I just feel like I'm gonna die.
Oh, you're poor, dear. Why is it you always have to be sick? You're the best girl I have. So sweet. And such a good girl.
Maybe that's what makes her sick.
Well, take an aspirin, darling, and go upstairs to bed.
Whatever you do, don't die till the second act or our play will be ruined, you know.
Good night, Jean, darling.
Good night, Mama.
Good night, Jack.
Good night, Mother.
The icing from Up the Icing, played by Frank Black and his orchestra. And now for the second scene of our play, Miniature Women. The next scene takes place 2 nights later by the old elm tree on the Gutgeld estate, where we find Tom Gutgeld waiting for his sweetheart, Joe, with whom he is madly in love. And the Chevrolet is the only car on the low price deal with any action wheels, which has nothing to do with this play.
I wonder what's keeping Joe. He promised to meet me here by the old elm tree at 8 o'clock. It's after 10 now, so while I'm waiting, I think I'll go home.
Tom.
Ah, here she comes now. Must have her heavy underwear on. Oh, well.
Hello, Tom.
Hello, Joe. How are you feeling?
Fine, Tom. Never felt better in my life. I sold my first poem today and got 60 cents for it. Ain't that good, Tom?
Well, if it's that winter poem you wrote, you're some salesman. Ah, Joe, but we're not here to talk poetry. Let's sit here by this old elm tree.
All right, Tom.
Love me?
And you?
Mm-hmm.
How much?
Oodles.
Eh?
I said oodles. And you?
2 oodles.
That's not bad in times like these. Say, Joe, we've known each other 9 to 15 years. We were brought up together. School day sweethearts. We've always lived next door to each other.
Say, Tom, that gives me an idea for another poem.
Oh, Joe.
15 years, we have been together. Rain or shine, all the time, in fair or sloppy weather. Ain't that good, Tom?
I still love you, Joe. Now listen to me. For years, I've been buying you flowers, candy, presents, taking you to theaters. Let's get Mary Jo and stop all this.
It can't be, Tom. It just can't be. Oh, I do love you, Tom. But I'm a genius, and I have a career that I'm a strive and work hard for. Someday, I'm going to New York, and I'll be famous. Then maybe I'll come back and marry you.
I see.
It might be 5 years. It might be 10 years. It might be 20 years. It might be 40 years.
Stop.
But I'll reach the top. And then I'll come back to you, if you still want me.
I see.
Will you want me in 40 years, Tom?
In 40 years, even RKO won't want you.
Oh, Tom, don't feel so bad. I'll always love you.
And I'll always love you.
And I'll always write to you.
And I'll always write to you.
And I'll always think of you.
And I'll always think of you, too. But, Joe, why do you need this career? My father's a millionaire.
Then I'll marry your father.
But listen, Joe.
No, Tom. The man I marry must be middle-aged, talented, gentle, kind, musical, and above all, economical.
Oh, I know. You want Frank Black.
Black? Who is he?
Oh, he's another millionaire.
That's only one man's opinion, folks.
Who's that?
That's Frank Black now. He's over there by the old oak tree with your sister Jane.
Quiet.
Well, listen.
The last time, Jane, I asked you, will you marry me?
Nine. I have a future behind me.
Our half hour is over. Anyway, we'll be with you again next.
to get a kiss.
Good night, folks.
This program has come to you through the courtesy of the Chevrolet Motor Company, world's largest builders of automobiles.